Electric cars are coming. We have heard this for a while, and SUVs are the flavor of the season. Another common refrain. Now how about the two together?
I like cold winter mornings in Delhi. It's so exciting. The air is fresh and clean. And what you see behind me, it's not pollution-laden smog. It is, in fact, clean fog. And if you want to keep it that way, you're supposed to be driving this. This is the MG ZS electric SUV. Yes, if you want to keep your environment clean, this is what you should be driving, and this is what we are driving today.
Yes, today we shall not get on to other debates like the source of that power. It is all about this green car. Our drive began at MG India's headquarters, and then we made our way through Delhi's early morning traffic towards Greater Noida in an effort to spend some quality time with the ZS EV. The ZS electric SUV features a three-phase permanent synchronous electric magnet motor, which makes power equivalent of 140.7 brake horsepower at 3500 RPM and has a peak torque output of 353 Nm. The power comes from a 44.5 kWh battery, which MG says is resistant to dust and is waterproof.
The first thing that anyone asks about electric vehicles is the range. Well, MG says that the range, the claimed ARAI range of the ZS EV is about 340 km. But we would like to believe that the actual range is about 280 to 290 km. Well, that's when you go easy on the peripherals such as music, air conditioner and so on. But otherwise, if you're pottering about in town, you shouldn't be worrying about range anxiety. Although, it is a very difficult concept getting used to.
The fastest charging option is the 50 kilowatt DC fast charger, which can charge the car up to 80% in less than an hour. MG says that its dealership in metro cities will have one unit each of the 50 kilowatt fast chargers, wherein you could pay and charge your electric car. MG will also install an AC home charger at your place free of cost, which will take about 6 to 8 hours to charge the ZS fully. Lastly, each unit of the ZS also gets a portable charger, which can be used to plug into any regular socket. But of course, it will take the longest time too. And finally, if you are stranded somewhere with no charge left, MG will send a van which acts as a mobile charging facility and get your car enough juice to reach the nearest charging point.
The first thing that strikes you when you're driving the ZS EV is the instant pull. The acceleration is bang on. The moment you step on the throttle, the pull comes along, and the good thing is, whenever you spot a gap in the traffic moving ahead of you, you just look at it, tap on the throttle, and you're already there. For city dwellers, this should be reason enough to switch to electric vehicles instead of regular IC engine vehicles.
That is thanks to the instant torque the electric motor gives you. Now, if we were to nitpick, the steering robs you of the fun that the motor is capable of. It feels lifeless. But in case you want to add some more weight, all you need to do is select the sport mode from the toggle switch near the rotary transmission knob. The brakes on the ZS EV are good and have decent progression, although we would have liked a bit more bite from them. So yes, the car has three drive modes: sport, normal and eco. And while the names will explain the difference to you, there isn't much difference in performance terms, which is surprising. Except for the slight heft to the steering in the sport mode, of course. Apart from the drive modes, the MG ZS electric SUV also has three levels of kinetic energy recovery system, which are light, moderate and heavy. In an instance where you're using brakes regularly, it is advisable to opt for the heavy mode so so as to recuperate more charge to the battery.
We quite like the suspension setup of the ZS EV. It's very well balanced. It doesn't mind the occasional pothole or the speed bump. But what pleasantly surprised us is the car's stability through corners. Thanks to the heavy battery pack placed on the bottom, the car, it sticks to its line and turn-ins are quite fun.
There is nothing about the ZS EV that betrays the fact that it is an electric SUV, except maybe the electric badging on the sides and the electric hum or whine that is a dead giveaway. In styling terms, it has a typical compact crossover proportion and stance. The design is understated and the front end, while it won't look dated, there's nothing new or stand out here like we saw with the Hector. That wide grille with chrome surround looks good though. And hidden within is the charging point of the car. Adding to the looks are the London Eye inspired DRLs and the very cool looking windmill inspired alloy wheels. That also add to the car's aerodynamic efficiency. The lines on the profile break the monotony and add a sense of relief. The rear end though is a little too generic. In fact, it does remind you of the Hyundai Creta straightaway, which is not great. But overall, it is a neat looking car. And the use of chrome all around, be it the grille, the door handles, the window line, and even the badging at the rear is subtle and not overbearing. The proportion and size are also good, as is the stance. The interior of the ZS EV has a clean, simple layout. And the all-black color theme, it gives that premium feel to the cabin. And further reinforcing that feel are these soft touch materials which are all around the cabin. MG will offer two variants of the ZS EV which are Excite and Exclusive. We have the top spec exclusive model for our test. MG understands the fact that buyers in the Indian market love a feature-loaded car, and the ZS EV caters to that. So then, naturally, you have a full panoramic sunroof as well. The ZS EV gets 6 airbags as standard along with ABS and electronic stability control. Oh, and the ZS scored 5 stars in the latest round of the Euro NCAP crash test too. But that is the made in China car, while this one is being assembled in India. We can hope for similar crash safety on this one as well. And yes, of course, this too is a connected SUV with all ZS customers having access to the iSmart EV 2.0 app, which gives you a status update of your car, finds the nearest charging station and do everything that the Hector does in terms of connectivity. And MG will offer Apple CarPlay and Android Auto soon on the top spec exclusive model soon. The MG ZS has the right proportions to be a city car, has enough range to do a 50 km commute every day for 5 days, is cleaner than a diesel or a petrol car, is loaded with features and offers solid performance too. The only thing that remains to be seen is the price. We expect it to be priced at around 25 lakh rupees, keeping it in contention with its only rival, the Hyundai Kona Electric. We have seen Indian cars scoring 5 stars in Global New Car Assessment Program crash tests in the Tata Nexon and Tata Altroz. And definitely Tata has set the bar high for passenger safety with its cars. But now, Mahindra joins Tata in finally having a 5 star rated car, and it is the Mahindra XUV300, which scores 5 stars in the latest round of Global NCAP crash tests. In fact, not only does the XUV300 score 5 stars, but it outshines the Tata Duo, scoring more points than the other two. It scored 5 stars in adult occupant safety and 4 stars in child safety, which is the highest rating that any Indian car has received so far, making it perhaps the safest car for children in India. The crash tests showed that the level of intrusion was the lowest in any Indian car tested. And the XUV300 also has the best side impact crashworthiness performance among all Indian cars that Global NCAP has tested so far. All cars tested by the Global NCAP are the entry-level variants of the respective models. The car's standard safety features include two frontal airbags. Electronic stability control and side impact airbags are optional fitments. Global NCAP noted that the structure and the footwell area was stable and it offered good protection for the head and neck along with the knees as well. The chest protection for the passenger was rated good, while for the driver, it was adequate. With the best side impact protection on offer, the XUV300 offered good protection for the child dummy with one of the child seats installed rearwards. The other child dummy was seated facing front and the car offered adequate protection to the dummy. Global NCAP explained that the lack of 3-point seat belts in all positions and the poor ISOFIX markings led to a 4-star rating instead of a 5-star one for child protection at the rear.
SUVs and electric cars. Both these have become cornerstones to success for most of the car makers around the world.
And Tata Motors is stepping on both these stones with the Nexon EV. Now it's precariously poised to either win or lose. But with the Nexon EV, it's saying that the company is here to stay in the EV space business. Now, of course, this is not the first car, electric car from the company. But with the Nexon EV, the company plans to kill that one big bird of success with these two cornerstones.
The first step then is to make it look the part.
So it is essentially the facelift of the Nexon, which is why you see a number of changes made to the car. You have new headlamps, you have new LED DRLs, then of course there are these blue accents all over the car, which actually give it that unique distinction of being an electric vehicle. But there are practical changes as well, like the bonnet has been raised and there are more other modifications to help it make basically comply with pedestrian safety norms, which will most likely kick in October 2020.
And thanks to the battery pack, the Nexon has gained weight. So the company had to think of not making it obese. The alloy wheels then are lighter than the ones on the regular car by 1 kilogram at each corner. Adding to the appeal of the electric car are the EV badges and the blue touches that are all over the car. And then there is the tri-arrow design almost all across the car, right from the headlamps, tailgate, even on the sides right here, and in fact even inside the cabin.
So you see the tri-arrow theme on the inside too, and of course there are blue accents all over the dashboard as well. So clearly it's an EV on the inside. But what's also new is the new steering wheel. Now that comes from the Altroz, and of course there's a 7-inch touchscreen infotainment system which gets Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, navigation via smartphone, and a lot more that you can do there. And then there is the digital instrument cluster, which is also 7-inch and gives you all the information you need about the way you drive.
So there's a graph which tells you that you are in eco mode, if you are using too much power or how much you have managed to regenerate and send back to the battery. The battery itself is under the floor, and you'd expect it to eat into the space at the rear.
But no, that does not happen. Of course, it's not a flat floor. There is a tunnel right here. But that does not eat into your space at the rear. There is good enough knee room for a person my size. And of course, there's decent headroom as well, as you can see. It also gets rear AC vents, but sadly, there's not a USB port here. There's of course a 12-volt charging for people who want to charge their phone at the rear.
Now, the trim we are driving is not the top end, it's the XZ Plus, and misses out on leather upholstery, rain sensing wipers, automatic headlamps, and an electric sunroof. But it does get connectivity features. And sadly, our car wasn't connected. But we got a short demo of what it was. The Nexon comes with an embedded SIM with 35 connected car features, right from vehicle statistics, remote access, along with safety and security options. So yes, Tata Motors has jumped into the connected car space. In fact, the company says that all its electric offerings from here on will have connected features. Details like the data operator and even the subscription plans will be known at the time of launch.
But of course, let's get on to what's it to drive like. I'm very sure you're eager to know what this electric car is all about. It's actually fun, and you don't miss out on anything that you feel in an internal combustion engine car. It's oodles of fun. There is 127 brake horsepower on offer, and of course there is 245 newton meters of torque available instantly. Of course, there are two driving modes. One is D, one is S. So if you're driving in sports mode, there is 60% more torque available at the front wheels. So at the switch of this button on the go, you're in sports mode, and it's just instant. There you go. And it's really very engaging, you know. But of course, when you enter into sports mode, the range quickly dips. In fact, we've been driving it since morning. It was about 96% in the morning, and now it's around 59%. And this involves both us driving on the highway as also in sections where we just push the car in sports mode. It is very interesting how that percentage of drop is actually equivalent to 1% per kilometer, and that's pretty big. But then again, there's regenerative braking, which you really enjoy, and you really find it incredible that you are saving some amount of energy.
So yes, range anxiety is a concern. And though the company has got an ARAI certified mileage of 312 kilometers on a single charge, our short drive did not really provide us with that. As you can see, with 85% and a range of 217, just 30 kilometers later, the range fell to 55%. Furthermore, just 46 kilometers later, the charge dropped to 34% and range was just 71 kilometers. In total then, that drop is significant, though some of it can be attributed to my heavy foot. But still, as far as charging the car goes, you can do it via a fast charger or home charger. Using a fast charger can give you 80% charge in just 1 hour, while the home charger will take 8 hours to power up to 100%. It's really interesting though that Tata Motors is putting itself out there to make a product which in India has no case supporting its guaranteed win, especially when charging infrastructure is yet to be settled upon. The electric car game is a gamble of sorts then in India. And with the Nexon EV, Tata Motors might not have won the jackpot, but it certainly has some good cards to dent the winnings of players who are already in the game.